A very good evening and welcome once again to the Clyde Auditorium. This evening, the centre stage operated and occupied by the best 56 kilo male weightlifters in the Commonwealth. And this is the championship title that they will be fighting for this evening. Alongside myself, David Goldstrom, we have Jeannie Lassen, former Commonwealth Games champion back in 2006 in Melbourne. And this is a competition early in the championships, but one we've really been looking forward to.
Yes, we've got some very strong athletes in the 56 kilo class and some countries looking to defend some long-standing titles.
For the last three editions of the Commonwealth Games, this has been almost a Malaysian benefit. The last three champions have all come from Malaysia, and it's Malaysia that holds all the Commonwealth Games records. This evening, we've got a competition which features eight athletes. There was a B group earlier in the day, and the best of those was Tanimowo Razak of Nigeria, who totaled up 225, which was a fair total, but based on the entry totals of the eight men who will be contesting this evening's finale, that shouldn't trouble the medal podium unless many of the candidates this evening fall by the wayside, and that really shouldn't happen. But again, we've got a very strong competition, a couple of Malaysians in here, two very strong Indians, South Africa, Sri Lanka, Pakistan, all represented in tonight's competition. And the Clyde Auditorium just filling up now. One or two who've been outside, perhaps looking at the triathlon and other events, now coming into the weightlifting this evening. And this is pretty competitive when we look at the entry totals. Two, three, four men around the 260 down to the 250 kilo total, and that makes it very competitive. So here you can see the competitors with the body weights that they weighed in the past couple of hours. The heavy man, this is Sangeeth Chandadara. There he is. Well, they've got 55 kilos on there, but we've actually got 55.98 on our body weight list as the heaviest man in there. So we think we're right.
Yeah, I think there's a good chance we're right. The biggest difference between his body weight and the lightest athlete is actually only 600 grams. So the lightest athlete is weighing in at 55.35. So we're talking about a bottle of water in difference in between what the heaviest and the lightest athlete weigh.
So the clock ticking towards 7:30 here in the Clyde Auditorium. To all of you with us around the Commonwealth, thank you for being with us. We really appreciate your company. As you see some of the records there, the world record and the Commonwealth Games record, those are the ones, the Commonwealth Games records are the ones really to take note of there. Amirul Hamizam Ibrahim there, a total of 260 to keep the 56 kilo championship of the Commonwealth in Malaysian hands last time in Delhi. And we've got a former champion from Malaysia in tonight's competition. So it really should be competitive stuff. And as ever, Jeannie, it's the athlete who really puts a really good sequence together. You're looking for athletes to put five out of six, or if ideally six out of six good lifts.
Yes, athletes are always trying to make as many lifts as possible. When you only make two or three out of six lifts, it's very difficult to get onto that podium.
Yeah, effectively your destiny falls into the hands of others. And just one little note here. If we have athletes who end up on the same number of kilos, of course the body weight will come into play. And the lighter
Ladies
man will always get the higher
girls,
position.
Welcome.
That's correct.
To Glasgow 2014 Commonwealth Games weightlifting competition.
So it's almost time to meet the contenders.
The lifters for the men's 56 kilogram Group A.
And the first man there facing you, this is Zuhelmi Madpisol from Malaysia, 20 years of age. Home for him is in Penang. Zul, as he's known to most of his teammates, Also, the Malaysian challenge, supported by this man, Mohammed Faisal Baharom, and won the title, this title in Melbourne, but is coming back after back injury, which Jeannie will talk to you about a little later on.
I know it all too well.
Representing South Africa, Heinrich Phillips.
From South Africa, one of five South African lifters here. Over him is Cape Town.
Representing Sri Lanka, Sanjeev Chandarara.
Chandarara for Sri Lanka.
Anticipating an exciting tournament representing Pakistan, Mohammed Shehzad.
Mohammed Shehzad for the Pakistanis from Faisalabad.
Representing Sri Lanka, Tanka Don.
So the second of the
Sri Lankans. Number seven, silver medalist in Delhi in 2010, fourth in the World Junior Championships in 2009, currently ranked 15th in the world, representing India, Sukhan Day.
Guy, this is a man who could have a big part
and
to play
right,
tonight.
To lift heavy weights today, representing India, Ganesh Mali.
And the younger of the two Indians, Ganesh Mali. Yep. And the Indians already with their tails up, having taken gold and silver
thank
earlier in the day in the women's
in
48
session.
Kilo competition. So there are your contenders tonight.
Thank you, athletes. You can return to the warm-up area.
And they have now 10 minutes to warm up to get ready for the competition. Much more about them individually as the competition gets underway.
And the athletes now have 10 minutes for final preparations.
But of course, the competition needs a good number of officials. It's been notable, Jeannie, that the officials have outnumbered the athletes so far. And I suspect it's going to be very much the same for this evening's competition. Of course, you've got a jury of five, three referees, that's eight already. Then you've got the doctor and a technical controller.
That's right. So just with the jury and the referees, we've tied the amount of athletes we're seeing compete today.
This competition, incidentally, also the very first opportunity to earn potentially qualifying points for Rio 2016 for the Olympic Games, an inaugural move in this year's Olympic cycle.
Yes, it's a great step in the right direction for our sport.
There's the man who sits in the centre of the referees.
From Swaziland, Udo Motsa.
Udo Motsa.
And from the Seychelles, Robert Rose. The reserve referee from Australia, Danny Waugh. The chief marshal from Sri Lanka, S.A. Wijayawardena. The timekeeper from Scotland, Alex Phillips.
Well, that just about sums it up, right here. If you're Scottish, you do get an extra cheer.
From Scotland, Frank Efferson.
Rightfully so, rightfully so.
From South Africa, Neville Swart. And from India, Carl Sandhu.
And Carl Sandhu there is the man who had the passion to set up and drive that women's development in India.
That's right, and now we see success with both the men and the women together. They're doing amazing things in their training center.
Thank you to all of our technical officials.
So away to their appointed positions. And of course, you can see that clock which says countdown. That's the athletes' countdown to get ready. So many of them now will be getting through their warm-up procedures, ready for the lightest of them to come in. But as you look at the start list here, the man who's likely to come on first, in fact, is going to be the South African, I think, Heinrich Phillips, who's posted an opening attempt of 95 kilos. Everybody else has asked for 100 kilos or more. So it may well be that Andrew Phillips will be following himself in the early stages of the competition.
That's right. He'll be lifting, and then 2 minutes later he'll be lifting again at a higher weight, but still lighter than the other athletes in the competition.
From South Africa, Kevin De Bruy. From Papua New Guinea, Frank Robbie. And from India, Suresh Sagar.
I think what's really important about the Commonwealth Games, and Ginny, you know this from all your involvement in the Commonwealth Games, just how particularly special it is for these athletes to be performing on this stage. For many, many of them, this is the biggest stage they've ever competed on. For a whole load of them, they've never appeared on a stage lit for television with cameras all around them. So it's a completely new environment.
That's right. Multi-sport games are very different from championships. There is the cameras, there's the village, there's so many other things going on that we don't have at traditional championships. So this is a really awesome experience. A lot of these athletes won't make it to the Olympics, and this is their Olympics.
Yeah, and it's been remarkable how the Commonwealth has actually improved the numbers here, the participation numbers, the biggest ever participation numbers in the history of Commonwealth weightlifting at the Commonwealth Games.
That's right, 240 athletes?
135 of them are men from 35 countries.
Amazing, 90 women, so not quite at 50-50, but quite close considering the newness of the sport at the Commonwealth Games. We've only been in since 2002.
Absolutely, and it's really important this for the development of weightlifting. Weightlifting's a core sport, as often many of you will have heard it described. That's in all the major championships, including the Olympic Games. But these days, every sport has to prove itself every 4 years. Every 4 years, it's reviewed at Olympic level, and now they're going to review them at Commonwealth level as well. And so you have to really develop your sport, not only for the athletes, but also the presentation of the sport to the public. And this is a major mission. So when we have so many athletes from so many, you know, 71 nations and territories participating, and 35 of those have got weightlifters here. So that's pretty good. That's 50% as near as matters.
Well, yes, and we have 29 for the women. So that's, again, pretty close to 50%.
Now, these guys tonight are going to have to be very, very sharp. They're not going to only have to lift well, but they're going to have to be sharp about the tactics, because everything's very tight and very close here, and a kilo or two is going to make a big difference.
A huge difference. When we were back talking to them before the competition and asking what personal bests were, we heard the same numbers all around, so it's going to be very tight competition here.
They're all pretty relaxed. They weighed in, or started weighing in, just a couple of hours ago. And here's a little journey around the warm-up room here. And you can see big competition platforms here, or training platforms. So really excellent conditions here in terms of kit and equipment.
Oh, it's great. It's very unique setup for the competition warm-up as well. It's kind of a U-shape, so you don't necessarily see all of your competitors while you're warming up, but I think that does add to a little bit of mystery when you come out onto the platform.
It means your coaches have got to be on their toes. There you can see we're just about 3 minutes away now from the first lifter, and looking forward to this competition.
So it is a challenge for the coaches, but I have to say for the athletes, this is a pretty sweet setup. It's nice to have your own little corner here. Be in your zone quite easily. So this is the A session of the 56 kilo class.
And that's really nice there. The two young women who were gold and silver medalists in the women's 48 kilos, a couple of hours ago, not even that, coming in to give a nice boost. There's Kunjarani Devi, the head coach herself, twice a Commonwealth Games gold medalist, all coming into the Indian boys to wish them luck.
Yes, there's some serious team spirit here. It's great to see. That's some great technique as well from that Indian athlete.
both of these Indian athletes from the seaside, so to speak, one from Calcutta, the other from Mumbai. So they have that sort of dart, and this is how the Indians fight their, find their lighter weight athletes. If you want to find the heavyweights, you start going into the interior of the country, where you find those heavier potatoes and vegetables and food, meat as well.
Here we see our younger Malaysian athlete.
So just before we get underway, about a minute to go. Earlier today, of course, we had the 56 kilo B division. Now, that was based on the entry totals, and the athletes who competed in that had lower entry totals than the men you're about to see. And they were trying to do their personal best and hope that perhaps one or two fall by the wayside tonight and maybe they'll move up the ranking. Now, the best of those was the Nigerian, Tanimowo Rasak, and he totaled up, snatch and clean and jerk, 225 kilos, and so he is the biggest challenger. But let me put that in perspective for you, because when we look at this evening's entry totals, the lowest total is actually 235, so that's 10 kilos above. And we move up to 260 kilos, which is the highest of the entry totals. So providing these men lift to their ability, then the man from the B group shouldn't be getting anywhere near the medal podium.
That's right, but he's sure happy to see his name on that scoreboard right now, I'm sure.
Here we go. Sit back with Jeannie Lassen and myself, David Goldstrom, and enjoy the final of the men's 56 kilo Commonwealth Championship for 2014.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're ready to start the men's 56 kilogram category Group A. Loaded, the first weight we have nominated is 95 kilograms. 95 kilograms for Heinrich Phillips from South Africa, first attempt. Lifted to follow will be Bissol.
So, Heinrich Phillips, he posted 95 kilos as his first attempt in the warm-up room, and he's coming out on exactly that. So the message we take from that, Jeannie, is that the warm-up's gone pretty well.
That's right, he's right on par with where he wants to be.
So please, when the lifters come out...
So he will definitely want to be improving on that. He's got a personal best of 97 kilos, so 95 is a good place to start.
Yeah, it's quite brave, actually. It's a gutsy move. He has a chance of beating his personal best on his second attempt if he does this well.
Coached by our former lifter, Avinash Pandu, 21 years of age. Home for him is Cape Town. And I have to say, a healthy bit of support in the auditorium for the first man, representing South Africa, 95 kilos on the bar. First attempt.
He's really spending a lot of time getting his grip here. And that's a very easy lift. He's clearly been putting in some serious work since he posted that 97 kilo result.
Holders, 96 kilograms.
Yeah, went to the Commonwealth Championships last season. Finished fourth there, but only snatched 90 kilos, so he's really tuned up for the Commonwealth.
That's right. I'd like to mention about the amount of time it took him to get his grip. The men's bar has a diameter that's slightly bigger than the 15 kilo women's bar, but these men in the 56 kilo class, they're not huge, so it could be a challenge for them to get their thumb around the bar and wrap their fingers around to really ensure that hook grip.
Terrific precision, great speed, good focus, wonderful first example.
It's a great way to start a competition.
Let's just hope now that performance is catching.
This will be for, will help.
That's right, let's see some green on this scoreboard.
To follow will be,
so the next man due on the stage at 100 kilos. And this is going to be the first of the two Malaysians. And this is Suhelmi Mudzol, 20 years of age. Home for him is in Penang. Penang, very much a competition centre for weightlifting. Commonwealth Championships have been staged there. And on he comes. The Malaysians also double-handed in tonight's competition. But in fact, a change. And it's
Chandara.
It is Chandara coming on for Sri Lanka. Chandadara, Sangeeth Chandadara, the heaviest man who weighed in the last couple of hours.
Just 600 grams more than the lightest athlete.
But it can still matter.
It does. In the case of a tie, it matters all the world. So you can see that he jumped back slightly there. So he did have a good pull from the floor, but when he completed his lift, he jumped back, which caused the bar to go forward and resulted in a miss.
This time, this will be for Heinrich Phillips from South Africa for his second attempt.
Well, he's quite fortunate, actually, because the South African wants his 100 kilos as his second attempt. So he's just got a little bit more time to put this right.
That's right. It is quite a stressor to miss a lift and then have 2 minutes where the audience sits in silence waiting for you to come back and repeat something you've just missed.
So very businesslike.
This is a great position to be in, coming in on your second attempt and trying a personal best at a games. He's taking quite a bit of time to get his grip once again. And a lot of athletes would get nervous staying in the bottom position and they'd feel their legs are being sapped of energy, but clearly this guy's leg strength.
Well, that's a...
I'm not sure about his elbow.
Yeah, I know. It was a good save in one sense, but they've given him three whites.
He didn't actually have a press out. He just didn't walk out.
Yeah.
Just putting my head over the parapet here just to have a look at the jury. They look pretty motionless to me.
He got lucky with that because he was able to lock out as we saw in the first lift, so usually that would be refused.
So of course, the 100 kilos, new personal best.
That's great. 3 kilogram PB after your second attempt.
So back onto the stage, Malaysia's man. In the, I should say, Sri Lanka's man, in the Sri Lankan army, which enables him to train full-time. And
that was the same mistake again. You can see that the weight is not heavy off the floor, but he's just maybe suffering from a case of the nerves because he's not completing the lift in the most efficient way.
Yeah, he's under real pressure now because there is only just one set of medals available in the Commonwealth Games these days, and that's for the overall total. So if you don't get any of your snatches in the first half of the competition, effectively you are forced to retire. You don't get a total, and it's a horrible journey home.
That's right. It's called bombing out in our sport, and you have a rough trip back to the athlete's village and an even rougher trip on the plane ride back home.
Yeah, and if your plane ticket says you can only go home next Monday,
it's a lot of suffering.
Yeah, you're thinking about it all the time. It happens. It's not nice. I mean, it happens in all types of competitions.
That's right. It happens in every sport in some manner or another. It is hard to take because 99% of our sport is training, and less than 1% of our time is spent on the platform competing for medals. So when you don't even have the chance to get those lifts in, it really stings.
So he's got a minute still, so plenty of time. Doesn't make it any easier though. Been lifting for about 10 years since he joined the army originally.
he's definitely found himself in a position where he needed his last lift to stay in the game before. Maybe not at a games, but if he's been lifting for 10 years.
Well, there's the support from the audience, but he needs concentration. Come on, drive up, and he's saved his day.
That was a great comeback. He might have put himself out of the medals by losing those first two attempts at 100, but he can be proud of himself that he managed to stay in the competition.
From South Africa for his third attempt.
And this is what you call a real pressure lift.
Very big pressure. And it's very hard to be precise in that kind of pressure.
But those two failures do compromise his intended journey.
That's correct. But now his journey has changed from going for a medal to just being happy to have a result.
So looking for a new personal best. And you know, if he does this, this will be 6 kilos up on his previous best. So this will be a great start, 3 out of 3.
If he can improve his timing from that last lift, he can get this with straight arms overhead right away. Personal gold medal right there.
And South Africa, you know, it's not a very rich country in terms of the money that's available for weightlifting. They have not more than 20 men, elite athletes, and probably about 15. They don't even have a major training center. They just have to do it here and there in their local clubs. So it's, you know, that's a really great boost for him and the other members of the team.
Yeah, that's amazing. 3 for 3, 6 kilogram personal best here at the Commonwealth Games. That's an amazing result.
Now, question is, he'll go backstage, give himself a little pat on the back, and then refocus ready for the clean and jerk.
That's right, you can't celebrate too much. You've got to save that energy for the next half of the competition.
So the bar moves on to 105 kilos now. And this is for the first attempt of Zuhelmi Madpisol, representing Malaysia. So this is the man who indicated he was going to come in earlier, posted 100 kilos. Obviously, the warm-up's gone well because he's put another 5 kilos on for his opener. So hopefully this is a realistic starter for him. He's just 2 kilos shy of his personal best. Already you get the feeling in the hall here, they're all aware that this is so tight it could go any which way, and you've got to keep yourself in the race.
Every lift counts. And that went up quite easily, but again, it's just a difference of centimeters between a perfect lift and a missed lift. And unfortunately, a little bit too much rotation on that bar, and he missed it. 5 kilograms.
And I can tell you the biggest opening weight posted comes from Mohamed Faisal Baharom, who won this title in 2006, and that's 110 kilos. And that's the heaviest opener, so you can see how tight we are already.
That's right, there's a lot of traffic at these weights, and 110 is a great weight to start at if you want to try to break that 116 snatch record for the Commonwealth Games.
Yeah, and that's held by a teammate, Amirul Hamizan Ibrahim, who is the man who won in Delhi. He actually also won in Manchester as well. As I mentioned, the Malaysians have done awfully well at this category. Last three editions have all gone for them. And now the second of the Sri Lankans coming out. This is Tilanka Don at 105 kilos. And he posted 103, but he's reacted as well by going up 2 kilos.
And his personal best is only 108, so we see these guys are starting really heavy. That's a very easy lift. Very solid start.
Very speedy as well. They're really explosive. You see the explosive power in the snatch, more so than really in the clean and jerk.
It's a much, yes, it's a very technical lift. Yeah. You see the transition and speed past the knees quite easily in the snatch in comparison to the clean and jerk.
You know, when you're in the training hall, for this particular lift, what are the exercises that you go through to perfect this?
Well, we do a lot of overhead squatting because, as you can imagine, getting the bar overhead is one thing, but maintaining the stability once it's over your head is quite a larger challenge, actually.
So, Zuhani, or Zul to his friends, out for his second attempt. Now, this is a perfect example. If he wants to stay in the chase, this has to be nailed.
He's got to keep his composure.
Now, he lost it behind. Quite often, you get the other problem of not pulling it hard enough and getting it up there and not getting under the bar.
That's great.
I'm delighted to say that he corrected it well. So he's on his way.
Up 1 kilogram to 106 kilograms. 106 kilograms for Ganesh Mali from India. First attempt. Here to follow will be Esau.
And what you're seeing here is really quick lifting. And this is actually a byproduct of how close these weights are.
That's right. We're not seeing any 2-minute waits between attempts for the same athlete. There's a lot of energy in this building right now, and it's awesome to be one of these athletes.
So it's going to be Ganesh Mali for India. 21 years of age. Second in this season's nationals, hails from Mumbai. 106 kilos to go into the lead.
Very easy lift. That is a great start. He's in a position to go for that Commonwealth record as well if he keeps up with 5 kilo jumps.
Interesting though, he posted 109, came down at 106, so he's actually doing two things. He's judging the competition, but also being realistic about how he feels.
That's right, maybe he just wanted to get one in solid lift in and he's going to take a bigger jump, or maybe he's decided to play it conservative in the snatch and save it all for the clean and jerk.
And Pakistan now on the stage. First attempt, up a kilo, 107 kilos on the bar. This man from Faisalabad, 107 kilos. He's got 45 seconds, so time aplenty.
He mentioned to us earlier that his personal best was 115 kilos. So he's another athlete potentially chasing that record. There's a rule that the only part of your body that can touch a platform is your feet. So if we watch him on his next lift, he may just be putting himself in jeopardy with that flexibility he's displaying.
But he is the new leader on 107 kilos. Pakistan is taking the advantage.
Very impressive.
And this is like the kilo creep at the moment. It's very cagey.
It's very cagey. That's a good word. This is a great fight so far. It's the best competition we've seen all day. B group or 48 kilo A group.
And the bar going up another kilo at the moment. It's surely not going to come out on 108. That's going to change.
That's right. That's the automatic increment.
And he wants more, so there's a change of call. So now 108 kilograms is loaded.
So Malaysia now, and
he's actually going to try it. This is still 1 kilo over his personal best.
from a rough start to a pretty decent end.
That's a very, very decent way to finish. It was a rough start, and it's very common that athletes get down on themselves after missing their first lift, and then they kind of lose track of their whole competition, but he's still in the game.
So that 108, of course, lifts him into the lead by a kilo. And Sukun Day, who's going to come on now for his first attempt at 109. And this is, on entry totals, one of the three favorites. Entered a total of 260. This is the man who won the Commonwealth Championships last November. Sukun Day from Pune. In the army.
Kicked it forward there. Didn't look too heavy coming off the ground, but just a small technical error, and it's a little too far forward, and there's no way to hold on to that bar.
109 kilograms. This will be for Telanka Dong from Sri Lanka. Second attempt. Lift to follow will be Day.
Sukun Day, who I should have mentioned really, was second in the Commonwealth Games.
That's right.
In Delhi. Then was a bit of a bad boy and served his time for taking an inappropriate substance, but has come back.
This athlete here, his nickname is Proto by his teammates, which means short.
So we're on 109 kilos now. And this is Telanka. Telanka Don.
It's his first Commonwealth Games. But he has won gold at the Commonwealth Championships previously.
He's okay.
No lift.
Second attempt, though, and this is where it gets crucial.
Yes, this is where the stakes rise.
109 kilograms for Sukun Day from India. Second attempt. Lift and follow
will be done. So Sukun Day, who's got a personal best of 115. Just building nicely at the moment. Or he will be if he gets this.
That was much better. You can see how much room he has for more weight there. But again, it's just so hard to maintain that perfect technique and control when you're trying to be aggressive and powerful at the same time.
So he's got a bit of a big question now for the third attempt. You know, I think he's got to at least put on 5 kilos. On the third attempt.
That's right, he's not the strongest at the clean and jerk, so if he wants to stay in the game, he really needs to gain some ground here in the snatch.
Still the man who won this championship in 2006 to start his campaign.
For your benefit, ladies and gentlemen, sometimes this happens. If there are say bodily fluids, it's not be blood that can happen and can go on the barbell to all the state, then it must be cleaned. It's taken off the platform and cleaned by the ladies.
So it's Telanka Don who's going to come on again. He failed at 109. This will be his final attempt. It's a 4 kilo increase from his successful first attempt. And of course, this 109 again would be a personal best. They're just cleaning the bar at the moment for him. Technical controllers should not let him on the stage, actually, until this is done.
Huge applause when this barbell goes back on the platform for our athletes.
This is just to keep control of the situation. And then you can see, just cleaning off, sometimes you just get a callus, it bursts, get a bit of blood on the bar, and for hygiene, safety, and health, bar must be completely and correctly cleaned.
That's right. And the bar does have some serious grip to it, so it does rip those calluses quite nicely.
Yeah, that's why some people favor one manufacturer's bar over another.
That's right.
This particular company is pretty popular, because actually on these particular bars, they're not that aggressive. You don't get too many cuts on these bars.
This is my personal favorite.
So Telanka Don to try and make good. full name actually, Taranka Don Karolislagi, representing Sri Lanka. Third attempt, 40 seconds still remaining for a PB of a kilo.
Oh, so close. I was so sure he had it.
Now, that's a real pity because his first attempt that was good is 105. Now, this is where an athlete like Tilanka starts to get left behind.
That's right. He really needed that 109 to stay in the game. And you could tell that he knows it when he walked off that stage. He was looking pretty disappointed.
So the next man to come on will be opening his account according to the planning at the moment. 110, that was the kilos that he proposed earlier on, so he stuck to his plan. Now this is the man who actually won the title in 2006, but then ran into a really serious back problem, Jeannie.
Yes, he showed us some pictures on his phone that he had taken of his surgery. He didn't explain entirely what his injury was, but he has fused discs now. He's got three screws in his back, and he doesn't have a whole lot of motion in that lower lumbar of his back.
And this is the sort of L4, L5
yes.
region, too close to that sciatic nerve.
Yes, exactly. I mean, a lot of people that don't even lift heavy weights have problems with that area of their back, so I'm sure we can all relate to suffering.
You're sitting next to one.
I mean, mine is weightlifting related, but I do experience some severe pain.
A huge cheer for the man who's looking to regain the title and also to keep the title in Malaysian hands.
He said he came here because he wanted to lead by example. He's coaching now. He's taken a little bit of time away from coaching so that he could come here and lift to the best of his ability.
He's 32 and keeps saying, I'm a bit old for this.
Clearly that age is bringing some great experience.
Well, 110 kilos on which he's opening is for him a realistic target after that surgery. Again, that is doable.
No question, very powerful lift. Just a little off in the catch position, but it's the first lift, and sometimes just getting that one out of the way is all it takes to get on the road to having a good competition.
So Sukhandev of India is the man who's leading at the moment with 109 kilos. Still has an attempt left. And Ganesh Mali of India rushing on.
After a very solid 106, this shouldn't be a problem for him, although he did have quite a weight between his first and second attempt. He's also one of the heavier starters at the clean and jerk, so every kilo he can gain himself here is just going to help him go for a bigger lead in the clean and jerk.
I tell you, there's so much Indian support around us, behind us, to the side of us here. If they're getting this on the stage here, this will feel a bit like a home match.
That's right.
Now from India to Pakistan, and Mohammad Shahzad, 110 kilos on the bar for him.
That's right, just a small 3 kilo jump, but just trying to gain every inch, every bit of ground you can with the snatch here.
One of a family of five children, three sisters, two brothers.
Got very low. As I mentioned before, that he has a great range of motion, great flexibility, just didn't have the stability there.
He's got one more go at it.
That's right. He's really not that far, so there's a good chance he can make it on a third attempt. His best lift is actually 115, so 110 is not unrealistic.
But it's still really close still at the moment. You've got Ganesh Mali on 110 kilos, and you've got Sukhandev on 109. Both the Indian lifters leading the way. So now, Malaysia, counter-attack. Second attempt.
And he's lighter than the Indian athlete who just succeeded at 110, so this would put him in the lead.
He needs to make this. It's his second attempt. The first one, of course, he lost. So to keep himself in touch with those two Indians, he's really got to make this.
He looked so confident, he thought he had it, and it was just a little bit too much momentum taking him backwards there. This is an athlete that competed at the Olympics 10 years ago, so he does bring a lot of experience with him. Definitely been in difficult situations before, so there's no reason to think he can't make a comeback and make that third lift.
We sense, though, backstage, that when we were talking to him, he's much more realistic about his abilities since that operation. I mean, there's no doubt that, you know, age and the operation, they're sort of all catching up on him.
Oh, that's for sure. I mean, it takes its toll. That's a lot of kilograms, a lot of tonnage he's lifted in his life.
So, Mohammad Shahzad, Pakistan, with us again. Now, this is his third attempt.
We know he can get under it, but can he hold it once he gets it over his head?
He's got 107. But this would be very sweet for him if he can make this. Coming down to 10 seconds.
So close. Such amazing range of motion. He's pulling that weight up maybe to hip height and then just throwing himself under there, and it's almost working.
I just sense, though, a little bit of uncertainty there. Coach, it's very difficult when you're coming down to 5 seconds and the coaches are actually shouting at you, and quite often it's counterproductive. He's got a clock just to his right-hand eye, so he knows.
That's right. He starts very low. He starts in almost a full squat position. Most people start with their hips higher than their knees.
I'm not sure his bottom didn't actually touch the floor there.
It didn't?
I think it did.
It did. Oh, yeah. So even had he held on to the bar, it wouldn't have counted.
He would have been red-lighted.
That's right. Yeah. That is a rare problem. This doesn't happen often, especially among the men.
Now, they often say, cometh moments like this, cometh the champion. This man is a champion, has been a champion. Is he going to be a champion at this moment? Because this is exactly what he needs to bring from the depths of his experience.
He doesn't look phased even in the least.
Too close for comfort, though.
Oh, I'm sure his heart skipped a beat there.
I tell you what, his coach, I'd love to see the heart rate on his coach.
Oh, man. Especially after experiencing such a similar situation earlier on today in the 48 kilogram class with one of their athletes.
So that's staying alive because he's got 110, weighing at 55-52. The other man who's got 110 is Ganesh Mali, but he's heavier at 55-81. So that 110 save actually put him into first place, the former champion.
That's right, and he's starting pretty heavy for the clean and jerk, so he's still got a good chance of getting that gold medal. Back.
And the clean and jerk's a little bit more forgiving, of course.
That's correct. A lot more forgiving, actually. Had he been a centimeter off like his first two lifts, no question he could have walked around and saved it.
So Sukhandev now to regain the lead. Oh no.
He rushed himself a bit there. You could see in the start position he went. Touched the bar and lifted right away. Just a few centimeters out to the front. No lift.
And that's his third attempt. And so whatever happens, he's not going to lead at the halfway stage. But his teammate could. Ganesh Mali. And he's the younger of the two Indians.
His third and final attempt.
Oh, he's moved down to 111 now. I'm not too sure what this move is about. He's only going up 1 kilo from his previous attempt. This is going to put him in the lead.
This is still, as you say, the kilo is enough to give him the lead. And it's...
What can happen, ladies and gentlemen, is there's a change out the back and someone
doesn't... Well, this is the last lift going in.
That's right.
That's so... The lift has gone down from 112 to 111. So thank you, loaders. 111 kilograms is now loaded. 111 kilograms for Ganesh Mali from India.
So, just to take a narrow edge, but it's really tight. Sukhadev's teammates got 109. Baharam, the former champion, 110. And Diesel, 108. So it's not a runaway.
No. That's an excellent lift. I hope he's not regretting not having put more weight on that bar. That's a great way to finish this snatch. Three solid lifts. He's not the heaviest starter at the clean and jerk, but we don't know what that really means. There could be changes of any kind in that warm-up room.
Absolutely. So it's Ganesh Mali who leads at the halfway stage of this men's 56-kilo Commonwealth Championship, but only by a kilo from the former champion, Mohammed Faisal Baharom, representing Malaysia. And then just behind on 109, the second of the two Indians, Sukhadev, silver medalist 4 years ago in Delhi. And right behind him is the second of the Malaysians. That's Tuhelmi Pizol on 109. And then you go down to 106 kilos to the best of the Sri Lankans. So what you're looking at here is what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 men separated but only by 5 kilos.
This is going to be an amazing clean and jerk session. I'm really looking forward to see how this plays out.
And there you've got that, in fact, 107 kilos there for Shahzad.
That's right, and he's starting at 135 at the clean and jerk, so that puts him in position to go for first.
So Indonesia, Malaysia, shaping up, then Pakistan, Sri Lanka. That's 6 kilos off the lead. That's still very possible.
Yes, this is anybody's game still.
Very good first half. Hope you all enjoyed it. And the boys are now into their 10-minute turnaround backstage. In fact, they've got less than 9 minutes to go before we see the first of our lifters out in the second discipline, the two-phase clean and jerk. And here are some of the boys backstage beginning that warm-up with just an empty 20-kilo bar.
That's right. They have to unload the bar and go back down to 20 kilos. What's going to be quite tricky is we have a lot of athletes starting at the same weight, so some of them might find that they only have 10 minutes to actually finish the snatch, get back there, and do their 8 to 10 warm-ups for the clean and jerk.
Glasgow 2014 wishes to provide all spectators...
I'm sure that they're running on adrenaline right now, though, so it shouldn't be that big of a problem.
Please pay
the Commonwealth Games record for the clean and jerk, 145 kilos, set by Amirul Hamizan Ibrahim in Manchester 2002. Just looking at some of the starting weights, well, Sukhadev at 137. You can see that 5 kilo increase to 142, 5 kilo increase again, would put him right on the threshold. And, you know, that sort of progress could actually win him the overall title.
That's right. I think that you know, I said earlier we may see a snatch record fall, but I feel like the clean and jerk, there's a much bigger chance, and I'm really hoping that that does play out for us this evening.
Yeah, and also the Pakistan lifter Mohammed Shahzad, who I think is going to be much more comfortable at the clean and jerk, has posted an opener of 135. So again, he can get pretty close.
That's right. The competition is won on the clean and jerk. You want to have that heaviest lift. You want to be the last lifter. You know, deciding, as you said earlier, being the one in the control of the destiny. So.
And so what's the speciality about preparation in the training hall for this particular discipline?
In the training hall, when you're doing clean and jerk, you want to be able to be strong when you're lifting from the floor. So, you know, this is where we do some of those deadlifts, you know, just that simple lift off the floor. We do some squats, front squats with the weight on our shoulders so that we're able to recover from the clean, you know, when we get buried with that heavy weight and driven into the floor. And then the jerk, you know, you want to be able to jump with the weight on your shoulders and throw it overhead as explosively as possible. So we do things like presses and then, you know, of course the lift itself.
But quite a lot of time in the clean and jerk, you'll see people fail because they don't have sufficient leg strength to drive up. So if you find yourself in that situation, what can you do to actually try and improve and get over that problem?
Well, you could do a lot of squatting. As I mentioned earlier, the squat really helps. The front squat is probably the biggest bang for your buck as far as exercises in the gym go, but also jumps, because essentially when you do a clean, if you watch the technique of a clean, it's essentially jumping with a weight. So you want to be able to do that both with and without weights. You want to be able to jump. So that's why a lot of athletes use our sport to get better at jumps as well, because they're so similar in nature.
So 56 kilos, as you can see, 112 kilos would have been double body weight, so we were just shy of that in the first half of the competition. 111, the best of the attempts there. Just over 5 minutes to go to the start, so if any of you are thinking of popping out for a moment of refreshment, this would be the moment to do it before we get going again.
And we can see our South African athlete there doing 110 kilo very easily. That's a power clean. That means he's catching the bar with his thighs above parallel to the ground. It's very hard to do.
And you can see that he's quite advanced into his warm-up.
That's right.
So he's going to be one of the earlier, if not the first starter. He'll be there in the early starts. He posted, this is Andrews Phillips, so 130. There's another lifter on 130, the 132. They're very, very tightly packed for the clean and jerk.
They're neck and neck, and so we have three athletes listed at 130, but who knows if they're all going to stay there. They may go up, they may go down, but my guess is they're going to be going up, and they're going to be hoping to trip up their opponents with their temp changes in the start of the competition.
Wax is made in a mold, which is then cast into metal. And then there's a process of cleaning them up before finishing and polishing.
So our Malaysian athlete here is only at 90 kilos. He's not so far along in his warm-up.
Just to the back there with the glasses and the balding head, Dominic Duer, one of the doctors, in fact, the doctor on duty here tonight from Germany. Really very good doctor, knows the sport backwards and inside out, and God forbid anybody has an injury, you've got a top man waiting to help you.
Yeah, that's very reassuring. There is not a lot of competition injuries, but when they happen, it can throw a wrench into things.
And the fact that Glasgow is a city that does things in, you know, in a different way.
So one or two have just drifted out, but they're now beginning to come back here. I must say, the atmosphere really good tonight. There are some empty seats, but the atmosphere is really good.
I think there's a lot of people out getting refreshments, as you suggested. We've got 3 minutes left to go before the competition, so I'm thinking those chairs may just fill up. So what I found interesting there, when we saw the shot of the Malaysian athlete, he was only at 90 kilos, whereas his competitor was already at 110, and they're both starting at 130. So this would be very interesting to see how it actually plays out in front of us.
Yeah, it looks to be, at the moment, the indications are that it's going to be Zuhelmi Magpizol who would come out at 130 to open up, but We've still got 2.5 minutes to go. That can all change.
That's right. That's the one we saw doing 90 kilos, so I'm guessing it will. Hopefully for him.
So the Malaysians still with a chance to keep this championship within their hands, but they're going to be pushed off hard by India and Pakistan. And I wouldn't put any money on any of these guys at the moment because it's too close to call.
Well, I'd like to go for the winner of the 2006 Melbourne Games because I feel like his age and wisdom is going to really come in handy when it comes time to lift that last clean and jerk that's going to have everything on the line.
He, of course, is Mohammed Faisal Baharom, who saved the day with that third attempt on 110 kilos. So just kept himself alive in this competition.
Yep, I think the guts he showed there, we're going to see them again in the clean and jerk, and that's what's going to be the game winner.
90 seconds to go. Loaders sit down, they've set the bar. Important job, the loaders. They not only have to do it speedily, they have to do it accurately.
Yes, accurate is very important. I've seen, as I'm sure you have at World Championships, when the bar is misloaded and there's nothing as disappointing as going to lift something you thought was a record and finding out that one side wasn't the same as the other, and so the doesn't count.
The other worst thing is if you don't lock the bar with the weights on, which I've seen in a competition, and a lifter with the bar right over his head, and then suddenly all the weights off one side just slide off. You can see it on YouTube if you care to go and have a look at it. It's one of the weightlifting moments.
Fails.
Yeah.
There aren't that many, as I said, but when it happens, they're spectacular. So nothing like seeing 200 kilos fall off of a bar.
It actually smashed into a computer on the secretariat desk, and believe it or not, I mean, these were sort of 25 kilos, 20 kilo weights, and the computer didn't break.
This would be the perfect time to be sponsored by that computer company.
Exactly, that's what we tried to do, but they wouldn't listen to us.
So this is the athlete they're focusing on right now in the warm-up. This is the athlete that's supposed to be starting the competition. He just did 120.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen.
So here we go.
The first weight we have nominated is
6 kilos. Separating the first half dozen. It's very open.
He doesn't seem to be moving, so perhaps he has a coach at the marshals table changing his attempt.
So 130 kilos asked for the first attempt of Anrich Phillips, the young man from the Republic of South Africa, who actually has got a 100% record. 95, 100, 103 kilos.
This kid is on fire today. His best ever is 131, and we see him here going for a first attempt at 130 kilos.
A man with a plan.
That's right. Very easy clean. And a very easy clean and jerk. I wasn't sure. He took quite a bit of time there in between the two lifts.
I think he's very organized. I think it's clear in his head what he wants to do. And he was just waiting long enough in his mind to make that move and make it with conviction.
That's great. I'm hoping that he's going to take a 5 kilo jump after an easy lift like that.
Well, I think he's fortunate here because there's so many people who want this weight or thereabouts. I'm hoping that he's not going to have to follow himself.
Oh yes, he went right to 135. That's very assertive move, just like the way he approaches the bar.
So representing Sri Lanka, the 29-year-old Sangeet Chandadara has a personal best in clean and jerk at 135. So again, a decent start here with 130 on the bar.
Got a little pin there. That bar fell on him. It wasn't the best timing. When you want to have a perfect clean, you've got to meet the bar at the highest point. Get it on your shoulders when it's at the highest point. And as you can see, that bar fell on him. So that's how come he ended up crushed and unable to stand up.
To be perfectly honest, he's in trouble now because, you know, he's in a situation now where he's only made 1 out of 4.
That's not easy mentally. And he was Commonwealth champion in Penang in 2013.
Yeah, just to underline, championships at Commonwealth level happen every year.
That's
Commonwealth
right.
Games every 4 years.
Just like Olympics and World Championships.
And that was the gold medalist at the 2011 Commonwealth Championships. And in last year's Commonwealth Championships in Thailand, Malaysia, he got the silver medal.
Chandadara is also a fan of dogs. He has a Labrador named Sima. That he likes to teach tricks to in his spare time.
A young Labrador, I think. So the bar sitting on 130 kilos because that's where it has to stay because Sangeet has to come out and try and make a correction.
This is very rough following yourself in the clean and jerk. 2 minutes does not feel like very much time. It does in the audience, though.
And you can just see from his body language here that this is a man who's under pressure.
That's right. Hopefully he'll fix his timing and this will be a simple clean followed by a solid jerk. That was much better. Still difficult, but much better. You could see that bar wasn't level on his shoulders when he went to drive it. It was much lower on the right side than the left. That makes it very hard to get a successful lift overhead.
But I think the even bigger problem was the fact that he outfought himself.
Oh, yes.
And, you know, it's almost like you just saw the belief evaporate.
I think the only thing you can be thinking in between the clean and the jerk is, yes, I can, and there's no time for any other thought.
Now, hopefully not, but he now faces a very horrible situation because he's only made one good lift. He's now on his third and final attempt at a clean and jerk. If he doesn't get this, he doesn't get a total. What does that mean? Well, he's very miserable for a start, but it also means that Tanimoro Razak of Nigeria, who was the best in the B group with 225, would actually move up into no worse than eighth place.
That's right, and this athlete competed in the 2010 Delhi Games, coming sixth with a total of 218. So we know that he came here with hopes of shattering that total. You know, starting at 130 kilos, the clean and jerk, 100 in the snatch, he wanted to do at least 230. And now he's facing the possibility of walking away with zero.
It's just not his day at the moment.
No, definitely a game changer with this lift. He's either going to go home very disappointed or happy that he was managed to pull off a total.
Remember, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, this lift needs your support.
Now,
you can't make too much noise, come on.
What I think he has to do here is to get a very straightforward clean, not fussy, just nicely onto the shoulders, and then within a maximum of 7 seconds, he needs to punch it over his head.
just needs to be as aggressive as possible, put all his frustration into this one lift.
This to save his day. Not to be, I'm
almost
afraid.
That one he rushed.
No lift.
So didn't even take the 7 seconds you suggested.
No.
He should have listened to you. I think that maybe that would have been what it took.
I think what was on it, I think the clean was relatively hard. He was thinking, I don't want to hold this weight any longer than I have to. But it just needed a tad more control.
That's right. It was a grind of a clean, and it's very hard after taxing your legs like that to then jump and throw the weight overhead and catch it solidly.
Well, it's always disappointing when a lifter fails to make a total, and, well, I've never actually asked you this question, Jeannie, but I'm guessing that in your career there must have been an occasion when you missed a total.
Yes, it happened to me 3 times. 3 times in the snatch over the course of my career, and it is really hard to take. But I think that that fear of that happening is what causes you to lift those heavy weights under pressure.
Now, Mohammad Shahzad from Pakistan coming out to open up here on 133. Now, he had posted 135. Sorry, this is Pisol.
Oh, there's a change.
No, another change.
Hello, this will be at 133 kilograms. Back on Glasgow, 133 kilograms. And this will be for Zuhelgi Pisol from Malaysia,
yeah,
for his first attempt.
So a quick change there. Now, Pisol, this is going up 3 kilos from his first attempt.
This is great considering he has a solid 108 kilogram snatch. This could take him anywhere, this first attempt.
So this will be for a 241 total. And this will start to open up the competition.
That's right, we're going to see a lot of traffic from here on in. I don't think we'll see many more two-minute waits here.
Absolutely clear in what he wanted to do, how he wanted to execute it.
That's right. So I think a challenge we're going to see here for the athlete from South Africa is he's going to have a very long wait before he does his second attempt and may have to do a couple of extra lifts in the back. But he is on fire today and it might not go against him. He's definitely the underdog and has a chance of doing very well.
So at the moment, it looks as if Mohammad Shahzad indeed is on stage now. Originally, he was going to lift earlier at this 133, but he's come out now on that weight. Now for him, this is a 2 kilo decrease from his posted weight. So again, wouldn't be too worried about it. He's just judging the circumstance.
That's right. Maybe assuring himself a total and then pulling out 2 great lifts on his second and third.
Yeah, because he only got 1 out of 3 in the first part. And that was 107.
So this is for two. This is for best.
This is for a 240 to go into second place.
There he goes, getting low, low, low again.
Puts the arms out, shortens the distance, drives up. That's good for me.
That's a very easy first lift. And then you'll notice that he barely had a grip on that bar before he started lifting it. No hesitation.
33 kilograms for Ganesh Mali from India. First attempt.
And again, I don't understand the technical controller. While the loaders are still correcting the bar, they should not let the lifter onto the stage area. But it happens. But this is the man who led at the halfway stage by 1 kilo, the first of the two Indians, and this is Ganesh Mali. 133 to go with his 111. So for 244 and the lead here for India.
Such clean technique. So smooth.
Well, the weakness was overhead.
That was unexpected, but I did notice that his elbows were quite high after the clean. He didn't really drop them in order to get that straight push overhead.
But happens. That's the hint, though, why he's coming at 133 and not coming in at 135 or 137.
That's right. Maybe he's feeling a little rattled by being the leader. He is young.
It's maybe one of those nights where he ends up by wishing that he did take 112 in the snatch.
That's right.
Now, nobody else wants this weight, so he's going to have to come out and follow himself. Sukhandei, 137 is his posted one at the moment. So Mohammed Shahzad has posted 135 for his next attempt. And of course, the former champion, Baharom, at the moment, he posted 135 as his opener. That really hasn't changed at the moment.
No, he may just wait for everyone to do their three attempts and then decide what he needs. So Mali right now has to be sure to be focusing on what he has to do and not about the attempt lost and the opportunity lost by missing that first weight.
Well, the clean was good, but again, he's using up petrol, so the next clean may not be quite as easy.
That's right. It is mentally hard to go out there knowing that you're not really gaining any ground from your last lift. Of course, making this lift will keep him in the competition.
Look at this. Great stuff.
I love seeing two flags together like that. That's great.
Take a bit of inspiration from that. Now, if he's really going to go for the podium, this is pretty essential.
Yes, he has to make this. He has to do an easy clean to save some energy for that jerk.
Was a little harder, but that was predictable. Fight. Oh, it's a little
challenging. I'm not sure about that elbow. It's that same elbow as last time.
That right elbow. Central referee.
He got lucky.
Throws a question mark out. Jury.
Oh, I see that jury's on the phone.
For the same lifter, Ganesh Mali from India, third attempt.
Oh, it looks like they're calling the announcer.
Yeah, I think that...
This isn't a personal call.
I've been informed that the jury have stopped the competition, so the competition has been stopped at the moment while the jury discuss something with the referees.
So the president, Gary Marshall of New Zealand now.
Sometimes happens, ladies and gentlemen, where there needs to be a discussion. So we'll
now, the question is, are they going to call all three referees or the two outside wing referees in? Because they voted it as a good lift and... Indeed.
Yeah, it's a very clear press out, as you can see in the rear in the replay. The challenge when you are on the jury is to not look at the replay. You have to go with what you saw originally.
But those are the advantages that television gives you these days, that you can see the replay.
That's right.
But at the end of the day, the most important thing is that every athlete gets the right decision.
That's correct. Because losing a medal on a press out is hard, but being the athlete who got it taken away because another athlete got away with breaking the rules, not easy either.
Now this is, I think, these of us, I think they're reversing the decision from a good lift to a fail.
The jury to inform me, as I say, well done, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, for all your participation. And don't be annoyed what's coming out. You proved them wrong. You were a lot louder than the crowd we had earlier. Well done.
This is going to be a very hard situation.
They're not as loud over in the aquatic centre as you are.
Very hard situation for this Indian athlete if he does come back on his third attempt trying to have a total. Out of the medals now, just trying to have a total.
Yeah, because that has been reversed and it's been given as a no lift. And this is tremendous pressure. The only thing he's gained whilst the competition's been stopped is a little bit more recovery time.
That's right. A little bit more than 2 minutes with all of this decision making going on. And the crowd is not happy.
33 kilograms to remain on the barbell for Ghanesh Mali for his third attempt.
The key thing which they need to, they didn't actually explain to the audience here, that the reason for the reversal was a press out on the right elbow, on the right arm.
That's right. And this is affecting not only the athlete that has missed the lift, but of course all of the other athletes in the competition who were expecting to lift next.
Yeah, they're sort of backed up.
That's right. So maybe they've got to do an extra lift at the weight that they did right before coming out onto the platform, so maybe an extra lift at 130, that isn't easy. As you said before, there's a gas tank with only so much energy that can be used, and we're tapping into it now by these kinds of delays.
He really needs this to make a total, so when he comes out, really raise the roof. As I say, you can't make too much noise. We only ask you full silent delay approach to platform. To lift up, if they want you to make more noise as they approach the platform, they will tell you that they will indicate. But
otherwise, you can't make enough noise. So I don't care what anybody else says, stand with the chant scream. Well, the crowd had just been wound up. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Sometimes the lifter prefers just a little calm.
Yeah, sometimes, but I don't understand why they'd want calm when they're trying to lift such a huge weight over their head.
This is well over double body weight.
This is a crazy turn of events, coming in as the leader and now just trying to hang on to a result.
Okay.
That was better than the last one.
Big effort. Oh, yes.
There we go.
That's fine.
No question about that one.
Great lockout on the arms, and that's a terrific correction. And he's unlikely to get a medal, but what he does do is stay in the competition. For the moment, though, he is the leader with 244.
That's right, and now he can beat himself up about not having lifted like that on the first attempt, rather than beating himself up about not being on the scoreboard at all.
So, well done, Ghanesh Mali, 244, representing India. He leads ahead of Pizol for Malaysia on 241. Third place at the moment, Muhammad Shahzad for Pakistan on 240 kilos. And then on 233, a bit behind, Anrich Phillips of South Africa, but he's only taken one attempt so far.
And he's had quite a wait.
So 135 kilos for the former champion, the champion of Melbourne in 2006, Mohamed Faisal Baharoum, the man who's had his back put together with screws and bits of metal.
Quite amazing.
Now, this 135 is to go with the 110. This would take him to 245. He'd go into the lead by a kilo, and he'd still have two attempts left.
It's a great place to be. Easy, clean. Just a little too low on that jerk.
No lift.
So, as we said before, the jerk is a bit more forgiving. He got quite low in an attempt to lean forward and catch that jerk that he pushed forward, but just a little too out of control.
It was after 2012 that he had the surgery. Well, there's another athlete who wants 135 kilos. So that's a bit of a mercy here for Baharoum, because this is Tilanka Don representing Sri Lanka. And like the man who's just preceded him, He only made one out of three in the snatch phase. And he actually only brings forward 105 kilos. So this will be for 240. And then it comes down to body weight, because on 240, he's vying for third place. Just looking at, he weighed in at 55-51. And the man who's currently in third place is Mohamed Shahzadun, 55-66. So this will actually take him into third place.
That's right.
First attempt. Very deep.
Quite a large grip at the jerk here.
That
was almost as wide as his snatch grip.
I know. I thought he was really going to make that as he slid his arms out, because he reduced the distance by which he had to chuck it overhead, and I really thought he was going to make that.
That's right, and he already doesn't have the longest arms, so didn't have very far to push that weight.
Now, that did that bar stay in front and his hips behind?
Second attempt.
Let's have a look here.
The side angle will help us on that one.
Flips.
I think his hips got behind.
That's right. I think he brought his front leg back second, when you really want to bring that back first to change the direction of the bar. This athlete has waited 10 attempts since his last lift on the platform.
I'm not going to say anything, because it's like the commentator's curse moment, you know?
That's right.
Just keep going. Just keep doing what you've been doing. Making them. 135 on the bar. Second attempt. 5 kilo increase to take him to 238. Big moment this for him. Heinrich Phillips, South Africa.
Amazing strength getting out of that bottom position. Oh, that's unfortunate.
No.
You only get one chance to dip and throw it over your head.
No lift.
It's the first glitch.
That's the first glitch, but I'm thinking he had to do at least three lifts in that warm-up all over again just to be ready to come out for this 135 since his last lift at 130.
He's got one more go.
He's got one more go, and this guy from South Africa works in an abattoir, so he's a bit like Rocky. If anyone can do it, he can.
Yeah, there's a sense of real determination and purpose about what he's doing there, and I'd love him to put it together for the final attempt, but talking about a man who has to put it together, it's the former champion, Baharom from Malaysia, and really, Malaysia's chances of holding on to this title really rest in his hands now. 135, this would take him to 245, and it would put him back into the lead, but remember, he missed his first attempt at this weight. That wasn't easy.
Not easy, and it doesn't look like it's in the best position. On the shoulders, there you go, and that's why it's not going into that perfect position overhead when he does the jerk.
So now he faces the same situation as Ganesh Mali faced.
And the same position he was in the snatch as well. So he told us his best lifts recently were 110 and 135, and he just came in here and started at those weights, so he knew he was putting himself in a pressure cooker. Clearly he thinks he can deliver.
But you know, even if he makes this third attempt, you're looking at the South African who's going to come out for his third attempt, first of all. But even if the Malaysian former champion makes this, he will have only made two out of six. And although maybe he'd go into the lead, that surely ain't going to be good enough to take the title. Not two out of six. Now,
I'm really hoping this athlete will get this. It'll be a great way to finish off his first Commonwealth Games.
The most fired up of all the class tonight, 21 years of age.
And ironically, the calmest demeanor in the warm-up area.
He had a personal best of 226. He's already smashed that. He's got 233. So, can it get better?
He can clean this easier and save his energy for the jerk.
Coming down to 10 seconds, though.
He sure does take his time in the start. That was better.
He has a chance. Needs to be balanced.
Great into the heels. He can do this.
Come on.
There we go.
Come on, get those feet in line. Do you know?
That was one gutsy lift.
Oh.
And three white lights, no less.
Lift of the championship so far.
That's a permanent win. It doesn't matter where you rank after a lift like that. That's a permanent win. That's one you can remember for the rest of your life. That was an awesome, awesome lift.
What a brilliant series. He's made 5 out of 6, and he's taken his personal best from 226 to 238. 12 kilos up. Well done.
In an international competition, this is a kid that's only ever been to 4 international competitions, the youth worlds, the junior worlds, and a couple of African championships. It's amazing to come out into this pressure, that long wait and lift like that.
And you can see his coach there getting really exciting, Avanish Pandu delighted. And the only thing is, incredibly, after all that, he's still in fourth place. Now,
he'll be in fifth place, I believe, in a second here, because this man will deliver.
Well, we said, cometh the moment, cometh the champion. That was in the snatch, and he delivered. Now he's going to have to do it for a second time. So, for the third time of trying.
That wasn't any easier. This is going to take a lot of guts. It's going to be a grind.
No.
Oh, I really thought he was going to pull through.
I don't think he caught that much better on his shoulders than the previous one.
No.
And I just think the days, the years are catching up on him. The other thing that's interesting is, you know, he was actually involved in poaching earlier on today in the winners' competitions. And I'm not sure that that's necessarily the best way to prepare for a major championship final.
That's right. It's a lot of stress, especially when the athlete does bomb out, as did happen this earlier today. But what I think is really important to remember is he said he wanted to lead by example, and he handled that like a champ. He didn't kick, he didn't scream when he missed. He smiled and walked off, and it's clear that he did his best.
Malaysia are not out of this because they've still got Zol.
That's right.
But he's got a lot of work to do as Sukhanday comes on to open up at 136. Now, this could be really interesting because he is only 9 kilos off the Commonwealth Games clean and jerk record.
And that was easy.
Commonwealth Games, silver medalist 4 years ago.
Ooh, I'm not sure about that elbow again.
It was a little untidy.
Luckily, only one referee thought so. I'm pretty convinced that this athlete has done more than the Commonwealth record in training, based on how easy that lift was.
The jury are motionless at the moment.
To follow will be Telenga Dov. Resolved, followed by Dov.
Great technique here. You can see how the weight was on his heels. He jumped through the bar. Perfect timing, feet landing on the ground at the same time as the arms extended fully overhead.
And there you just saw taking that left foot back to be in line.
That's right. So when you take the foot that's forward back, you change the momentum in the direction of the bar when you have the bar going forward and you bring your back leg back first. Throws everything off.
The chase is on. Second attempt for Zol of Malaysia. So this is a 3 kilo increase. This will take him to 244.
Ties him with the Indian athlete, but unfortunately he's 30 grams heavier. I don't know that the coaches are aware of this.
So it would still keep him in third place, effectively.
That's correct.
But this is all about tightening up. At the moment, it's India in the driving seat.
That's right. easy clean.
Wow, Malaysian coach is going wild.
Very solid lift. That could have been a first attempt, no problem.
So he's only a kilo off the lead at the moment, but he's running out of lifts. He's only got one more attempt, so they may have to wait on this and play for the highest stakes.
That's right. I really feel like they should have done a kilo heavier there. They might be kicking themselves later, but he is very strong, and I think it's very likely that he will get his third attempt.
And Sugandey, by the way, who lifted so easily moments ago, has pushed his next attempt up to 140. And Tilanka Don of Sri Lanka to 139. And the next man who's going to come out is surely going to be Mohammad Shahzad, representing Pakistan, 137. This is a 4 kilo increase. Now, this would take him up to 244 as well.
But he's also lighter.
55 kilos, 66. And he would then have one attempt left as well. I think the man who's really got the chance here is Sugandey.
Yes, you're right.
245 with two attempts to go, and he's looked very strong.
Yeah, that's a great position to be in.
But the truth is, he's still only made two out of four so far.
He's clearly come into this competition much more prepared and strong than the other athletes.
So Pakistan.
That is incredible leg strength to get buried in the bottom position like that and then stand up.
He stays where he is.
No lift.
That's a real pity. That was his crucial moment.
That's very taxing.
If he got that lift, he would have just been keeping pace. And, you know, I'm not saying the gold, but maybe the silver or the bronze were, you know, within shouting distance. He was close enough to do that. This has now become harder for him.
That's right. You really want to assure yourself a spot on the podium and then go for the gold when you're in a game like this.
So if he comes out and he takes the same weight again, yes, he would move into third place, but there are too many lifts out there, too many possibilities.
That's right. You'll be left sitting watching the screen in the back, wondering what will happen rather than being in the driver's seat.
So the bar's been loaded to 137 for Suhelmi Mudpizol of Malaysia. Now, this is only a 2 kilo increase. It would take him to 246, which would put him into first place. Now, this is a tactic here, because I think what's happening here is that the Malaysians are probably accepting that they're not going to get the gold.
I really hope that they are going to change from this 137, though. Yeah. 136 was quite easy. I did just see a Malaysian coach walk by, and the buzzer has rang, so it looks like he missed his chance, and he has to do 137.
Which is ridiculous.
It's quite unfortunate.
Sorry, I said 135. It was actually 136. Yeah, this is silly.
This is a waste of an attempt.
55.84 his body weight.
He could have just done this on his second attempt.
And he's going to go from third to second if he makes it, but that's all.
Well, thankfully he made that. It was very rushed. It wasn't what was planned, I'm sure. But it might be enough to stay on the podium.
I think they're going to be kicking themselves. I think that's a coach. I think that's a coach's error.
That was a big coaching error, all right.
So
it might have been lost in the mix when the other athlete was, you know, on the doorstep of bombing out.
Now Shahzad here. They put the bar to, where they've gone to 138, very wise, because what they're doing now is playing the body weight. He weighed at 55.66, so they get 5 kilos up here. That'll put him 245. That would put him into second place.
That's right. He'll be tied with that Malaysian athlete, but unfortunately, less than 20 grams separate the two of them. 200 grams, sorry. And yes, this is how medals are lost at this level.
Succeeds in moving to the first place.
Come on, ladies and gents, you can do better than that. A bit more noise.
He's going to have to stand up as fast as he can once that weight lands on his shoulders to just not little, get buried.
Just a little uncertain as to Telinka Dom for Sri Lanka, who had a failure at 135.
And is going up to 139, it looks like.
Not to be.
Well, that's a good turn of events for the Malaysian athlete.
No lift.
So at the moment, it's gold for
Day.
139
kilograms. 139 kilograms for Telinka Dom from Sri Lanka for his second attempt. To follow will be Day. Dom followed by Day.
So this athlete is lighter than the Indian athlete. So yes, if he makes this lift, he will be in bronze.
Yeah. Yeah, the 139 going with the 105. So he's attacking at the moment Ganesh Mali of India.
That's right, he's going for podium or nothing right now.
Why don't you go to 140 and have a go at the Malaysian?
Good question.
We just found out why.
Little lack of confidence, but now he knows he can get it to his shoulders. Maybe he can go out there with a little bit more confidence on his third lift and get it.
And he still has the opportunity to put that bar up.
That's right.
Now the Indians are being absolutely right. They're not being distracted about clean and jerk records.
No, that's right. They're going for the gold medal. You never know what will happen, though. This athlete might find himself in the position that everyone else has done, and he's only with a lift left, and he can go for that record.
Yeah. Because this is a 3 kilo increase to take him up to 248.
That's right. He'll be untouchable. That's a very, very easy clean.
Now.
Amazing jerk. Sometimes I think the only thing harder than doing something you've never done before is doing something you've done 1,000 times before under pressure. He did it amazingly.
It's a make or break situation. He hasn't succeeded with either of his previous attempts. If he makes this, he'll get a bronze medal. If he misses, nothing.
Do you know, I'd be really tempted to put 140 on that bar.
If I were,
is it going to make a big difference, the extra kilo?
To go for second rather than third.
Yeah. I mean, it's not going to happen. He's going for the bronze medal.
I would go for the silver if I were this athlete. 1 kilo more. Just enough to fire you right up. Not going to get this lift, but I think he's going for it just out of pride right now.
No, he's been red. That was oscillating on the bar as well.
Yeah, it was no lift for a multitude of reasons. Yeah. The first being that he didn't catch it on his shoulders, and then he double racked it, we call it, when you push it up after the fact, and then the oscillating when you get that bar bouncing so you can get the rebound and throw it over your head easier.
So Sukhandeh has won. And now, the moment.
Suspected, he's calling for 146.
So, the first record attempt here.
And the first time I get goosebumps of this game. I'm sure it's going to happen several more times. Many more records will be attempted.
Well, Sukhandeh has posted a personal best of 145. So, this is territory which is familiar to him, and there is no pressure. He is the champion. This has been India's day, both in the women's 48 and now the men's 56.
And the Indian coaches are trying to control the audience, but I don't think it's going to work.
plenty of time.
Oh my goodness, I did not expect that. That went up so easily. But it was a big jump.
But it means that India, in the shape and form of Sukhandai, are the champions of the men's 56. They take the gold medal. They also take the bronze with Ganesh Mali, who managed to survive and just lift 244. He takes the bronze. And in between, it's Zuhelmi Mdi Pitol of Malaysia who takes the silver medal. So one has to say here, after the success of the women earlier today, this has been India Thursday.
That's right. It's been an amazing competition, a real nail-biter. Look at all that red on the board in the clean and jerk. That means everyone was gambling high stakes.
So confirmation coming up of those final positions. Oh no, they happy. Really gets the Indian challenge going. And there, Sukhandai. These are the performances from the clean and jerk. Wins that by a couple of kilos. Of course, no medal for that, but a great contribution towards his gold medal. And then look at the South African Phillips there with 135 personal best. What a performance by him today. And below there, those are the men who, well, will find a quiet corner to hide in because it's just not gone their way.
No, it's very deceiving to work that hard and have that kind of outcome, but this is what makes the sport.
By 3 kilos, Sukhandai is the champion of the Commonwealth at 56 kilos. Pitol of Malaysia, 245, just a kilo ahead of Mali. Shahzad of Pakistan, he had his chance but couldn't make that last attempt. And up into a splendid 5th place and a fantastic set of new personal bests, the South African. So it was always going to be tight. And it was always going to be about who made or didn't make their lifts.
That's right, and quite a few bomb outs, 4 on 15 athletes.
So what a day. India, gold and bronze in the men's 56 kilos, and of course in the women's 48 kilos earlier in the day. Sangeeta Kumkuchan taking the gold ahead of her own Indian teammate, Chanuwa Saikom. So 4 medals for India on this day. I hope you've enjoyed the action with Jeannie Lassen and myself, David Goldstrom. Of course, medal ceremonies to come, and that'll be shortly. So here's just a reflection of how our evening has gone. 8 men set out on a journey in this A final. It was always very close. And these, the lightest of the 15 categories. Astonishing lifting by this man.
That worked out really well for him. We thought he made a major error in deciding his attempts, but it worked out well. And big, big deception for this athlete, returning champion from 2006 in Melbourne. But as he said, he was here to lead by example, and I think he handled himself like a champion. And now he'll turn his efforts to coaching the future athletes of the Commonwealth Games from Malaysia.
The truth on this day, India had the march. They came here, they were very well prepared. Their tactics were good. They read the competition very well indeed.
That's right, they won the poker game. They didn't only win the strength and the power game, they won the poker game today.
It's funny how it goes, isn't it? 4 years ago in Delhi, it was a rocky start. Suddenly, 4 years on, and they got it all right.
That's right, sometimes from failure come your best successes.
So Sukhandai goes from silver in Delhi to gold here in Glasgow.
I can't even imagine how good that gold must feel for him right now.
So just a reflection on what has been a really good first day. I hope you've really enjoyed it. So much more to come here in the Clyde Auditorium. And so just to round things off, momentarily we hope the medal ceremony to honour the new Commonwealth champion at 56 kilos.
And hearing the Indian anthem for the second time today.
the achievers, the gold, silver and bronze medalists, the men's 56 kilo championship of the Commonwealth about to take its place, and the presentation party followed by the achieving athletes.
Led up by the long driver representing the Scots Guards, Lance Corporal Gary Swinnerton. The medals will be presented by David Webster, OBE, a special guest of the Commonwealth Games Association of Scotland.
Well, David Webster there being introduced, but Dr. Thomas Ian, President of the International Weightlifting Federation.
David Webster is the lifetime president for Scotland now, Scotland Weightlifting.
The winner of the bronze medal, representing India.
So the bronze medal going to Ganesh Mali of India. 111 kilos in the snatch, 133, but only at the last attempt, giving him a total of 244 kilos. And his heart must have been fluttering, because there were many who challenged for that bronze medal position. But at the end of the day, he did just enough four out of six successful attempts.
That's good statistics. If you can do four out of six in all of your competitions, you're
Dr.
doing
Ian,
very well.
Dr. Ian, in the opening congress here when we were deciding the final entries,
the procedures,
delighted to see such a good turnout of athletes here. Well, they've won the last three editions. They couldn't quite do it this time, but it's Zuleini Mpisol who has taken it for Malaysia with a best snatch of 108, a best clean and jerk of 137. He was much stronger in the second half of the competition to take the silver medal by just a kilo, 245, to take the silver medal.
That's right. You do exactly what you need to win the medal, and you put what you need on the bar, not more, not less, and that's what they did.
But he was vulnerable for 10 minutes.
He was very lucky that no one surpassed him.
But the man of the evening, and at the end of the day, the class act, even though he only made three attempts, but he effectively won it with three out of five. India's Sukhanday moves up from silver in Delhi to...
his home country.
And so for the second time on this first day of the championships, the national anthem of India. Since 1950, since Commonwealth Games weightlifting began in the men's division, India win for only the third time the 56 kilo championship. The last time, Pandian Arum Ugam in Kuala Lumpur in 1998. But this evening is all about Sukhanday, right in the centre of your picture. Congratulations to all three of the medalists. Tomorrow we move up the weight categories. The women contesting the 53 kilo category, the men at 62. Another really competitive day in prospect. But for the moment, from Jeannie Dusson and myself, David Goldstrom, thank you for watching, thank you for your company, and do be with us if you can. If not for all, but at least part of the day, because the Clyde Auditorium, the atmosphere, Jeannie, has been terrific.
It's amazing. I love the atmosphere here. I can't wait to see how the week go on and build as the weights get heavier and heavier.
So it's farewell for the champions who can celebrate now. The wonderful thing about doing well on the first day is you've got the rest of the championships to just celebrate. You can enjoy the village, you can enjoy Glasgow, and you can enjoy, if you're Indian, all the fans that have come here to actually urge you on. And that, remember, gold and silver in the women's 48 kilos, now gold and bronze. This has certainly been India's day in the Clyde Auditorium, the home of Commonwealth weightlifting.
That's right, four athletes and four medals. You can't ask for better than that.